Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to fix if File Explorer is not working on your Windows 11 operating system. File Explorer is the default app you will use to manage all the files and folders on your system. And if it is not working, the problem must be fixed. Let us see how you can fix it with different solutions. Starting with solution number one, in this case, you have to simply restart the Windows Explorer process. For that, right click on the task bar and select task manager. Go to processes tab, scroll down until you find Windows Explorer. Just select it and click on the restart task button at the top. You will see all the UI visuals will be gone after this. Since the Explorer is being restarted, you can just minimize the task manager and let the Windows Explorer process be restarted. After this, the issues you were facing with the File Explorer should be resolved. If not, carry on the troubleshooting steps next. Now we have solution number two. In this case, I simply recommend to restart your system, or you can also shut down. Just press the Alt plus F4 keys on your keyboard. You will get this shutdown dialog, which will help you to close all apps and then turn off the PC and then turn it on if you select the restart option there. Just select the restart option and click OK. Next, we have solution number three. So if restarting the Windows Explorer process and restarting the system didn't help you, we will try to clear out File Explorer history. And for this, we will go to File Explorer options. On the General tab, make sure you set Open File Explorer to this PC. And then next to Clear File Explorer history, click on the Clear button. Once this is done, simply click on the Apply and then OK. Up next, we have solution number 4. Under this solution, we will check for file corruption on our system and try to fix it. And for this, we will open command prompt. So search for cmd on your Windows 11 and select command prompt. As a result, click run as administrator, and in the administrative command prompt window, you have to type sfc space slash scan now and let the sfc scan be completed. This may take some time to complete, but this should fix the system file corruption, and that would help you to fix the File Explorer not working issue. In case if sfc command found some corruption but did not able to repair it, you can next try dism command, and for that you have to again open command prompt as administrator and paste this command from the video description and press the enter key. This would help you to completely fix the file corruption on your system using the DISM method. Next, we have solution number 5. In this solution, I suggest you to make a quick scan of your system for virus and malware. Just go to your Windows security and click on virus and threat protection, and then select quick scan and let the quick scan be running. In case if you are using any third party antivirus software, make sure you make a quick scan of your system using that antivirus. If there are any security threats present on your system, that will be cleaned out by your antivirus, and that would help you to fix this File Explorer issue. Now coming to solution number 6. In this solution, I suggest you to run System Maintenance Troubleshooter, and for this we have to open Control Panel. Since the troubleshooter is not available yet in the Settings app troubleshooting list, when the Control Panel opens, next to View By, select small icons, then select Troubleshooting. Under System and Security, click on Run Maintenance Tasks. And here you can see that System Maintenance Troubleshooter is there. you can just click on next to it, then select try troubleshooting as administrator and let the troubleshooting be completed. Once it is completed, file explorer issue should be resolved. Up next we have solution number 7. Under this solution, I suggest you to install the latest updates available for you. Simply open the settings app and then click Windows Update. Here you can see that system is now checking for updates automatically. If there are any updates available, you just need to make sure that you install them. And once latest updates are installed, hopefully the issue must be fixed. Next, we have solution number 8. So in case if you have already installed the latest updates on your system and the issue started occurring after that, then you need to uninstall the latest updates you just installed. And for this, we have to again go to Settings app, then Windows Update. Here you can see that I have installed all the latest updates because no new updates are available. On that page, scroll down and click on Update History. Then scroll down Next until you find Related Settings heading, and here you have Uninstall Updates. Just click on it. Here you can see that I have one update found which I can uninstall. So here you can uninstall that update after which you are getting this issue. Once the update has been uninstalled, the issue will be resolved. And finally, we come to the last solution for this video guide, and in this case we will reset the file explorer. Simply right click on the start button and select run. In run window, type sysdm.cpl and click OK or press the enter key. In system properties window, switch to advanced tab. Under performance, click on settings. In the performance options window, switch to advanced tab. Now under the virtual memory heading, click on change button. And finally, on the virtual memory window, uncheck automatically manage paging file size for all drives option. And then again check it back or enable this option back and click OK. And then you will be asked to restart the system. Simply do that. Once you restart the system, the file explorer will be entirely reset. And after that, the issues you were facing with the file explorer should be resolved perfectly. In case if you are still facing the issue, do let me know your comments. I'll be happy to help you. And that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.